So we begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
In the waters of baptism, Lena, Gussie, Johnson died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him eternal glory.
You shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far in safety, though you do not know the way. You shall speak your words in foreign lands, and all will understand. You shall see the face of
Almighty God and Father, it is our certain faith that your Son who died on the cross was raised from the dead, the first fruits of all who have fallen asleep. Grant that through this mystery, your servant Gussie, who has gone to her rest in Christ, may share in the joy of his resurrection. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
All please be seated for the word of God.
The first reading A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The just man, though he die early, shall be at rest. For the age that is honorable comes not with the passing of time, nor can it be measured in terms of years. Rather, understanding is the hoary crown for men, and an unsullied life, the attainment of old age. He who pleased God was loved. He who lived among sinners was transported, snatched away, lest wickedness pervert his mind or deceit beguile his soul. For the innocent mind, having become perfect in a short while, he reached the fullness of a long career. For his soul was pleasing to the Lord, therefore he sped him out of the midst of wickedness. But the people who saw did not understand, nor did they take this into account. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life. Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life. God is my shepherd, so nothing shall I want. I rest in the meadows of faithfulness and love. I walk by the quiet waters of peace.
Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life.
Though I should wander the valley of death, I fear no evil, for you are at my side. Your rod and your staff, my comfort and my hope.
Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life.
Surely your kindness and mercy follow me all the days of my life. I will dwell in the house of my God forevermore.
Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into
a reading from the second letter of St. Paul to Timothy. Beloved, I'm already being poured out like a libation, and the time of my departure is at hand. I have competed well. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. From now on, the crown of righteousness awaits me, which the Lord, the just judge, will award to me on that day, and not only to me, but to all who have longed for his appearance. The word of the Lord.
Deacon Mike, may the Lord be in your heart and on your lips, that you may proclaim the gospel worthily and well, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus answered Andrew and Philip, "The hour has come for the Son of Man to be glorified. Very truly, I tell you, unless a grain of wheat falls into the earth and dies, it remains just a single grain. But if it dies, it bears much fruit. Those who love their life lose it, and those who hate their life in this world will keep it for eternal life. Whoever serves me must follow me, and where I am, there will my servant be also. Whoever serves me, the Father will honor. Now my soul is troubled, and what I say, Father, save me from this hour. No, it is for this reason that I have come to this hour. Father, glorify your name." Then a voice came from heaven. "I have glorified it, and I will glorify it again." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We are gathered here at St. Gabriel Church this morning to remember Gussie Johnson, not just her 87 years here on earth, but also her new life in heaven. There's tears in our eyes, there's lumps in our throats, sadness in our hearts, because we love Gussie, and she's a big part of our life, and we're going to miss her. Grief is a normal thing, and we should be comfortable with that grief and know that the grief shows our love. If there are no tears in our eyes and no lumps in our throats, no sadness in our hearts, then there is no love. However, we do have to be careful. We have to be careful that our grief is not selfish, that we're thinking about ourselves more than we're thinking about Gussie. Gussie is now with God in heaven, sharing everlasting life and everlasting happiness, never to feel pain again, never to hurt again. So deep in our hearts, in a mix of all that sorrow, in a mix of all that pain, in a mix of all that grief, there should be a sense of joy. Joy that someone we love so much is now with God, sharing that everlasting life and everlasting happiness, never to hurt again, never to feel pain again. Gussie and I were, I think, good friends. I came here in 25 as senior associate. I was retired, and I came here, and I was senior associate at St. Gabriel for 10 years. I left at 2015 and got my own place. So I know Gussie real well. I ran into her many times. We were together several times, and she's always the life of the party. She's always fun to be with. And I never knew what was going to happen when I was with her. But that was okay. It made life more interesting. And she and I got along really well. I liked her because she laughed at my jokes. But Gussie was a fantastic woman, a woman of faith. Her faith was very important to her. She's always at Sunday Mass and attended several of the things we had at St. Gabriel those 10 years I was here. Her faith was vital to her, very, very important to her. Gussie lost her husband about 15 years ago. I'm not sure, but I think I had the funeral. And I was just here when he died. I was only here about a year. And so, you know, that's hard to give up your loved one, to give up someone you spent your life with, someone you became one with. That was very difficult for Gussie to lose her husband. And the last year of Gussie's life was very difficult. She fell and hit her head, and she wasn't quite the same after she fell and hit her head. And she was in the nursing home for that year. And it was a hard year for her, I'm sure. But I'd like to suggest something. I think Gussie's pain and frustration and hurt and her widowhood and her loss of John all brought her closer to God. Now, how can I say that? We have to look at Jesus on the cross to understand that. In a second reading, Jesus said, in the gospel rather, Jesus said, "My hour has come." His hour was his passion, death, and resurrection. He had to go through his passion and death to reach his resurrection. And actually, when Jesus was on the cross, it was the lowest point of his life. Here he was, nailed to that cross, hand and foot. He had been deserted by his own people, turned over to the Romans to be crucified. One of his own friends, best friends, betrayed him for 30 pieces of silver. And Peter, the head of the apostles, denied he even knew him 3 times during the passion. And here he was, hanging on that cross in terrible agony and terrible pain. At that time, Jesus yelled out, my God, why have you abandoned me?" Some people thought Jesus was giving up, that he was fussing at God for not taking care of him, not making sure he didn't suffer this terrible death. But actually, if you know your scriptures, you know Jesus was not giving up, just the opposite. Jesus was praying. He was praying Psalm 22. The first line of Psalm 22 is, my God, why have you abandoned me?" In the first half of that psalm, Jesus is pointing out to God in his prayer his sufferings. "They have pierced my hands and my feet. They have numbered all my bones. They divide my clothes among them." But the second half of that psalm says, "God, you're my Father. I know you will take care of me. I know all looks hopeless right now, but you're my Father, and you'll take care of me." So instead of giving up, Jesus is showing great faith in God the Father. And of course, the Father heard his prayer and brought him to resurrection after he died. Barnabas Ahern, a scripture scholar who is now deceased, he was a wonderful scripture scholar, has a nice spin on all this. He tells us when Jesus was praying Psalm 22, crying out, my God, why have you abandoned me?" He was clinging to God. Now we're talking about the human Jesus. He was clinging to God, and Barnabas Ahern tells us that clinging to God brought Jesus into special union with God. Now think about it for a moment. What is special union with God? It's resurrection. It's new life of God in heaven. So God did answer Jesus' prayer, and God did take care of Jesus, and Jesus knew that would happen. I tell you now that Gussie and her grief for her husband and all her sufferings and pain that she suffered during her life, especially that last year, she clung to God. And by clinging to God, she came into special union with God. And that led her to resurrection, to new life. What's our consolation? You know, we've given up someone we love so much, someone dear to our hearts. We're going to miss her greatly. What's our consolation in all this? It has to be our faith. Faith tells us that death is not an ending. It's a new beginning. Death is a door, a gate to new life. And each one of us in this church at one point in our lives will have to walk through that door of death. And when we walk through that door of death, we're going to be reunited with Gussie and reunited with all our loved ones and reunited in such a way we can never be separated again. I think that's our consolation. We will see Gussie again and we'll see her forever. Never sharing the same everlasting life, same everlasting happiness as she's sharing. And we'll share with her a love much deeper than any love we felt on this earth, because our love in heaven will be much purer and much deeper and much richer. So let that be your consolation. Yes, Gussie's gone for a while, but we will be reunited with Gussie and share with her that everlasting life, that everlasting happiness in heaven.
Trusting in the providence of God, now let us offer our prayers and petitions to the Lord. God, the Almighty Father, raised Christ his Son from the dead. With the confidence we ask him to save all his people living and dead.
We assemble here in faith and confidence to pray for our sister Gussie. Strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of your Son's coming. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Our sister Gussie, who nourished at the table of the Lord, welcome her into the halls of the heavenly banquet. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the family and friends of Gussie, that they may seek comfort and consolation, heal their pain and dispel the darkness and the doubt that comes from grief. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who loved and were loved by Gussie, that we may find comfort in our belief in the Lord's promise of eternal life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Those who trusted in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment and rest and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for a moment, let us now be with our own memories of Gussie. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God, our shelter and our strength, you listen in love to the cry of your people. Hear the prayers we offer for our departed brothers and sisters. Cleanse them of their sins and grant them the fullness of redemption. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Lost, but now
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands
for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Gussie, we beseech your mercy that she who did not doubt your son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling stands to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with the angels and archangels, with the thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Joseph our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant Gussie, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who was united with your son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also all our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Let us pray together the same prayer our Lord Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us turn to one another and offer a sign of peace.
This is Jesus, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. And happy are we who are called for the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, my soul shall be healed.
Shelter of the Lord, who abide in his
to shine like the sun and hold you in the palm of his hand. The snare of the fowler will never capture you, and famine will bring you no fear. Under his wings your refuge, his faithfulness your shield, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun. Wings, peccatoribus. Nunc et in hora mortis, nostrae.
Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son I left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our sister Gussie may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Gussie, and now we come to the last farewell. There is the sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Gussie again and enjoy her friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ.
May choirs of angels escort you into paradise, and at your arrival may the martyrs receive and welcome you. May they bring you home into the holy city, Jerusalem. May the holy angels welcome you, and with Lazarus, who lived in poverty, may you have everlasting rest.
Into your hands.
Before we say the final prayer, I have a little poem or prayer that I would like to read. I leave my thoughts, my laughter, my dreams to whom I have treasured beyond gold and precious gems. I give you what no thief can steal, the memories of our time together, the tender love-filled moments, the successes we have shared, the hard times that brought us closer together, and the roads we have walked side by side. I also leave you a solemn promise that after I am home in the bosom of God, I will still be present whenever and wherever you call on me. My energy will be drawn to you by the magnet of our love. Whenever you are in need, call me. I will come to you with my arms full of wisdom and light to open up your path, to untangle your knots, and to be your avenue to God. And all I take with me as I leave is your love and the millions of memories of all that we have shared. So I truly enter my new life as a millionaire. Fear not at my departure, you whom I have loved so much, for my roots and yours are forever intertwined.
Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister Gussie in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. Merciful Lord, turn towards us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with the assurance of faith. Until we all meet in Christ, we are with you and with our sister forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
In peace, let us take our sister to her place of rest.
Be a gathering up in the loft. If you go right across to the church, there's a door 25 upstairs. If you can't make the stairs, we do have an elevator, but there's a